Hello, you malty merry ones. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 134. And this is the concluding vlog relating to the 2010 Faisal Islay Whisky Festival taking place on Islay for the duration of a week, in which all sorts of whisky fans and anoraks flood the island and storm distilleries, waiting for hours and hours, in fact at times waiting all night, to get that extra special festival only bottling of variable standard and variable prices. I tend to avoid festival times myself, guys, because I like distilleries when they're quiet rather than busy. It's just a personal thing. When you're over in Islay, by the way, if you get there, you'll probably learn that folk from Islay are called the Ileach, which is Gaelic. And if you're buying any commemorative bottles from the island, it's worth getting a copy of this. This is the Ileach, the newspaper, the independent newspaper for Islay and the Isle of Jura. And it's got all sorts of interesting local information and snippets and adverts and obituaries and stuff. And here we are, Bruach Laddie, getting a full page spread, because this edition of the Ileach is the one 2 weeks before the festival. Right, now what you do is you buy this newspaper, only costs £1, and you roll it up and you stick it in with your bottle, your commemorative bottle, and not only do you have the bottle in your collection for ever so many years, but you've got a little bit of local history as well. So there you have it. Got to think out the box, you see. Make your collectible a little bit more collectible than other collectibles. Alternatively, you could just drink the stuff and enjoy it, as we will be trying this, another Ileach. You'll find this in the whisky shop in Bowmore. This is where I bought it. How much was it? £32.99. Lovely. And it's cask strength. And it's a single malt. And it's got a nice recyclable cardboard box. Lovely. There it is, a way to get recycled. Ooh. This tends to be a highly regarded, highly recommended cask strength whisky from Islay for those who love the peat stuff. It is 58% volume, and it's from a single malt, so it's from one single distillery, and it's a whisky to enjoy with a cigar, because even if I'm not quite enjoying the whisky, I can continue to enjoy the cigar. Oh. I have been sticking my nose in this for the last couple of days, and I am getting return visit to loads of new make spirit. Now, I recommend if you visit a distillery or have the opportunity, have a smell, a good long smell, and have a good long taste of the clear raw spirit that is coming off the still prior to going into casks. Now, a simple reason for this, guys, is a point of reference. It means that in a few months, a few years' time, when you lift a glass of whisky and you go, oh my goodness, that really smells gummy and kind of grain raw, and the kind of nail varnish remover. If you're wondering what that's all about, it's the new make spirit. And there's a whole load of it in here. Not even the great wallop, whacking great dollop of peat that is in evidence can mask the fact that this is very young whiskey, in my opinion, a bit too young. Even a year, 2 years would make all the difference. And it also suggests from the heat and the slight acidity that's hitting my nose is that it's coming from a still that's running a little bit too fast. Oh, it's gone out. Never mind. This, as you can see, has got quite a glow to it. It has caramel in it and it shows. If it didn't have caramel in it, I reckon, such is the youth of the whiskey, that would probably be the colour of white wine. A lot of refill bourbon casks involved here. Not so much the sherry. It's pretty fierce in the nose. You're going to add a lot of water to this. Young. Tastes young. There's a pause. There's a real sharp, and it's peat sharp. Attack of peat, not so much smoke. There is a sort of sultana, clove, cola note as the peat starts to recede a little bit. This has won awards. In fact, they're so proud of their awards, they've gone and stuck it on as part of the label, Gold Award. Well, not today, ladies and gentlemen, not today. I've tasted this before and it was a lot better, but it's worth noting that as whiskies become more popular, as demand grows, distillers feel obliged to put more out there, and that means using younger casks and younger whiskey, which means despite all the claims that whisky is consistent, it is not and never has been. Not even the blends. They're certainly more carefully managed by the blenders who generally do a magnificent job, but even they change over time because of the change of the ingredients, change of the style of maturation, the place of maturation, the quality of the casks, the quality and style of the yeast. The speed of the whole operation, everything impacts in a little way to create a big result. I'll try this again. Now I've added a fair dollop of water to it. It does help. I do recommend with these kind of young, slightly hot whiskies that if you put some little drop of water in and let it settle down for 5-10 minutes and come back to it, then you will be better rewarded for your patience. Very Bowmore. That's better. But in fact, adding water, and you can add plenty. Adding water's actually brought out the new make youthful nature of this. Well, I'd be surprised if it's anything over 6 years old. But it's certainly no Kilhoman, that's for sure. Marks out of 100. Well, it's going to be a malt mark because this is a non-distillery specified single malt from Islay, and I'm going to give it 82 out of 100. So there you are, you fellow malties. Hope you enjoyed this, and this concludes our little Islay session.